2022 is here, and I love this year for you, Cancer. So it is a year of advancement, growth, and really meeting some of the desires and needs that you've been wishing for. I'm very excited as I look at how empowering this year is for you. And along with the messages will come the best ways that you can address situations to maximize value in your life for meeting all of your goals. So when we look at the overall energy, the message from Spirit is that conclusions are within reach. Be very watchful. You are ruled by the moon, and you rule the fourth house of house and home. Everything that is foundational in life, nurturing. We see the full moon eclipse. So watch for the full moon eclipse. We will be talking about that this year. We will talk about those energies because you will be able to really maximize the progress you make this year based on what you learn at that time and at those times of eclipse seasons. When we look at the magic of the year, the magic that you can really empower your life with this year, is that of the observer. We see a woman. She is focused very intently, looking through an old-fashioned camera. She's patient. She's waiting for that exact moment. She's focused. She's not allowing anything at all to distract her. And that's where your patience, your power comes in this year. The magic of this year is watch closely, stay focused, stay patient, because you'll be able to take advantage of the right opportunities at exactly the right moment. It's a very magical energy, and it is yours for the year. You own it, my friends. When we look at the leaving, the energy, I always call this the mystical. The fairy oracle, heart of the fairy oracle, is all about the human psyche and how we respond to the magic and the mayhem in our lives. The leaving really speaks to the fact that you may have left something or someone behind in the year 2021. You may be leaving a pattern, a thought, a way of doing things, a person, a place. But as we see this youthful person here, very much like the Fool card, looking at the elder, it's time. It's time to own your adventure. It's time to leave a lot of things behind that simply don't serve you. You are at a full manifestation point. 5 and 4 equals 9. So you are ready to start a new cycle with this leaving. Embrace the journey. Show gratitude for the past. Thank all of those who helped you get where you are today. But it is time to take that first step on the road to building everything that you've ever wanted. This is a year with the number 6 in which you will find growth and stability. The animal spirit, the animal wisdom, is the owl spirit. Owls see very clearly at night. Most animals, most creatures do not. Again, that energy of seeing clearly now. We see you waiting for that right moment after leaving something behind. It is a time in which you can create magic in your life by simply being patient, by being willing to allow things that have not served you, that have brought you difficulties, to just, you don't have to ever forget them. You don't have to leave them behind emotionally. You can always cherish and show gratitude with the leaving, and that's where your power is to be grateful for all the magical things that you've had happen in your life that have made you who you are today, because you're powerful. Uncovering treasure. Beneath the surface lies a great bounty. I really see this as your inner core. Beneath the surface of the life that you have been living, maybe really feeling a bit overwhelmed by, dig deeper, have patience, and be willing to simply take steps into the future, allowing your journey to unfold as it goes. When we look at your taroscope energy, you are going to be in a leadership position. We see the feminine emperor in this deck. There are two emperors, but the feminine one is one who is really very much involved with people, places, things, activities. You're very much a leader. You could teach right now. What we see is that you can strategically work and juggle a lot of opportunities, a lot of people, a lot of energy of juggling a lot, even in business. This is a very strategic card. It's Aries energy. It speaks to the fact that you have every tool that you need for this year to present yourself, whether it be in an interview, whether it be dating, whether it be, you know, business opportunities. We really see that you have the power. You are a leader this year. Even if you're not thinking about that, you are very likely to be thrust into the limelight. When we look at your house of partnership, we are looking at the Ace of Swords. You have clarity. This is air sign energy. You have great clarity. You know the key to your happiness. You know what you require in any kind of partnership. This includes marriage. It includes any partnership that has a legal aspect to it. A doctor who cares for you has a legal requirement to treat you in a very the safe way to help you. Lawyers have a responsibility to you legally. Business partners are chosen with written agreements. Your marriage partner is a person with whom you're going to sign the legal document of a marriage certificate. The Ace of Swords says that you have great clarity. It can be also financial planners, but you are going to have, and most likely, strike new contracts in your life with the Ace of Swords. That is like signing the paperwork for the coming year in your relationship status. And as with the Ace of Swords, with all of these, this energy around you, I feel as though you will be making many choices that will be very successful for you. So when we look at your earned income and everything you value, we see the Queen of Wands, a fiery queen. She is a temptress. She has the sunflower she's holding in her hand. You are going to be so happy with all the energy that you put out. The Queen of Wands is a consummate businesswoman. She's out doing her own thing. She's excited. She's enthusiastic. She loves to win. And that is your energy. Winner, winner. We say chicken dinner with a Six of Wands, which is Leo energy, but it is no match for your beautiful Queen of Wands. You are going to manifest like absolutely like that wand is a magic wand. And you are waving it with great vigor. People think you look good. You look amazing. You are presenting yourself in an amazing, positive way with a fair degree of leadership this year in terms of all of your personal goals over what you value. You know, it's earned income. It's everything that you value, including relationships. The Moon and Venus join together with this energy of the Queen of Wands. You have the power to get everything you want with or without a partner, completely by yourself. Now, when we get the Devil card in your house of a partner's money or a partnership, we also get investments. We get inheritances. We get the energy of banks, loans, 401ks, investments. So right now we see you feeling very much compelled and compulsive about really it's sort of like passive income also. We see you very much focused on that, very much looking to see what you need to do, very chained to the idea of increasing abundance there. It is Capricorn energy. The house is usually ruled by Scorpio. Scorpio and Capricorn are very powerful determinants in whether you will succeed. The Devil card says, hey, I am not giving up until I meet my and reach my goals. And according to the energy of your journey, the oracle of your destiny and your journey is that beneath the surface lies great boundary. For those of you who are dealing with someone who has, if you've been in a divorce with the Judgment card, or you've had someone in your life who has left your life in any way, it does indicate that there may be cleanup on aisle five, as I like to call it, meaning that the year may be filled with some sort of traversing legal boundaries and issues, because that's where the seventh house is. So we go to the house of how you communicate, your brothers, your sisters, your local neighborhood, your car, contracts. We have the Three of Cups, dear friends, relatives, siblings. You are going to be in a space that allows you to be very happy. This is your local neighborhood. These are your close friends. These are your siblings, your contracts. Three of Cups is a card of celebration. So you look as though by the time you finish the year 2022, you will have found a power in your friendships, contracts, and a reason to celebrate the sheer neighborhood, the joy of that which is around you in your immediate environment, and contracts. It looks as though when we get the Three of Cups, it's usually bridesmaids dancing at the wedding. Oftentimes when we look at the Four of Wands, we get that Three of Cups energy. With the Ace of Coins, with the Three of Cups, we start to look at the potential for engagement. So we see in your ninth house now, of everything that's legal, everything that would be a court-related function. So if you're going to court for everything, judgment turns in your favor. It's celebratory. If you want to go back to school and learn new skills, you could be the teacher. You could be the pupil. It is a wonderful decision to make. Judgment card is Scorpio energy. It's leaving things behind. It's allowing a season like winter to die away and give away to spring. We see this beautiful archangel. It is Archangel Raphael, the triumph, the horn. It is really your time to step into your life in a big way. Not that you haven't already, but this will be a stellar year in terms of the results that you will achieve. It is also a card of karma. Cancer, you are some of the most delightful, loving, wonderful people in this zodiac. And this is your chance to really have the good karma that you deserve in the legal system. So many of you will be traversing a period of time in which you have much to celebrate. We have the fourth house, and this is your mother. This is everybody that nurtures you. And the fourth house is your house, Cancer. This is where you are the landlord or the lord of the fourth house on the zodiac wheel. And that is your history, your heritage, your beginnings. And the Six of Pentacles say that you enjoyed much love in your life, that you've had aunts, uncles, whether it be friends, you've had a group of people in your life that have given to you, with whom you got to share something very, very precious. We get the energy of the Queen of Swords here also in your 10th house. This foundational energy that you received is going to be what's powerful. When we look at the energy of the Six of Pentacles, you may be buying a home this year. You may get a loan of some sort. You may have an inheritance that allows you. The Six of Pentacles can be inheritance money from, a mother, a father, or it can even be an inheritance that you deserve because of acts or good deeds. You know, can be good karma. When we look at the Queen of Swords energy in your 10th house, many of you are in this very powerful energy of being in a role of judgment, of actually making decisions about other people. You may, for many of you who are involved in finance, if you're involved in finance, you may be the loan officer that rubber stamps the approval of a loan. You may, but this is a very elevated, very responsible energy. It's Libra energy. Again, with the seventh house, which Libra rules, with partnerships, with business, you are going to have an absolutely incredible ability to see the truth for what it is, the whole truth, nothing but the truth, and make the right moves. When we look at your fifth house of romance, this can be children. It is also everything that you manifest from your body, from your mind. It's also relationships. If you have any nephews, any nieces, any children of your own, if you are a teacher, the Six of Cups is a soulmate energy. The Six of Cups is Scorpio energy. It's people coming back into your life and having fun with them, meeting up with people that you've known a long time. It is a year of romance, of passion, of fun, of enjoyment, of pure pleasure. It's also going to give you the opportunity to express your creative energies in a way that nurtures your soul and your heart. When we look at the energy of your 11th house, of your friends, your associations, and the groups, it looks as though you're doing quite well. This is your energy, Cancer. Here you are in your reading. We have the High Priestess energy. You are in, you are, many of you work in an environment where you work with a lot of different people, so which is Aquarius energy. And what we see is that you're very discreet in your business relationships with others, in your group endeavors with others. If somebody were to confide in you, you keep it a secret, and therein lies a treasure that is hidden. That when I look at the friendship, the Three of Cups card in your house of communication, the Six of Cups, and the High Priestess, there is going to be much that comes to the forefront for you in which you will have great reason to celebrate your astuteness, your tactfulness, your kindness, your generosity, your nurturing in those environments in which you are very powerful and you are well respected are going to bring you great joy this year, because look at what happens. Here you are just being your elegant, cooperative, best self out in the world, and look at what happens. Your day-to-day life becomes that of the Magician. The Magician card is ruled by Virgo and Gemini. And look at, Gemini is your house of friendship this year. This is a Three of Cups, your friends. When we look at the Magician card, it's Virgo. The sixth house is the house of Virgo. You have all of the tools to live a jubilant, happy life. She's holding this big goose, the goose that laid the golden egg. She's wearing a party hat. She's with friends. And nothing seems very terribly difficult this year. You feel as though your life is very beautiful, very magical. It is also a time when we look at your fifth house to your sixth house. We see now the second house of romance means that you're going to attract an absolutely lovely, amazing chemistry with a lover. You have all the tools to get exactly what you want. When we look at your Four of Swords, this is the house of Pisces. It is a house of healing. It is a time for you to rest on your laurels. You have all these feathers drifting down. I feel with the leaving that's happened in your life, I feel as though there's a time when you need to recover. You are going to take good physical care of yourself. You're going to get a lot of rest, a lot of relaxation. It is a time in which your dreams will be very significant. Jot them down, because when we get this Emperor energy with this magic moment, you know, the observer energy waiting for that magical moment, you are going to be able to manifest in your day-to-day life that which comes to you in dreams when you're resting. Now, I like to do two card spreads that really speak to challenges or delightful situations. It could be relationships, it could be situations. It can be, a, you know, how you feel about something or a process that you're going through. So let's look at the shadow deck first. This deck is usually what challenges you, but it doesn't always. So we see the hidden self. Okay, so when we look at the shadow self, but the shadow self is hidden right here. So what I'm seeing with you, Cancer, and you are a water sign, you have the tendency by nature to be the high priestess, to be very discreet. What we see is a lot of who you are has been hidden throughout your life, especially in the Two of Cups relationships. The Two of Cups is a bride and groom, usually, you know, at the altar, they're making their vows to each other. And I really think that what this means is that when you're in love, you don't like to rock the boat. That's what it means. And I think that you may have had a habit of suppressing your needs, of saying, no, I'm okay. You know, whatever we do is okay. Whatever you want, you're so giving. You are so giving. And I think the Judgment card is calling on you now to claim what is yours by all rights. We get the Devil card. Okay, so we get the Devil card here. So it means that this is a toxicity, or it's created for you, a toxic way of basically allowing other people to catch you in a bind, to catch you so that you feel tied to them and them not being as responsible as they should be to you. When we get the Devil energy, we also get maybe a partner who never wants to share their income, their wealth, their assets, but they're glad to take. That can be metaphorically. They can take from you and not give you what you need, sort of like a goat is not really a carnivore. So it really speaks to the fact that you may have been involved with somebody who had a very unhealthy view of relationships. No shade, Cancer. This is the adventure of life. This is how we learn. And most of us, I very seldom ever seen a reading in which, you know, as the for the collective, that we didn't get some sort of Devil energy over the period of a year. It's just part of life. The Tower card, the Awakening card. I love this card. The Tower card is Aries energy. When we look at the Judgment card, it's Scorpio and Mars energy, which is also Mars is also the Tower card. So this is a beautiful epiphany. It's like waking up in the middle of the night to the magic of knowing that the exact right time has come to leave toxicity behind, to understand that you see everything clearly and to trust yourself, and to know that beneath all of that, what may seem like a tragedy is absolutely the best luck that you could have. The toxicity dies off, Cancer. The Wheel of Fortune is here for you. The Six of Swords is moving forward in this healing energy in the year of six, right? 2022 adds up to the number six. This is your year, Cancer. Wheel of Fortune. You know, when we look at the energy of beneath the surface lies great bounty, you're going to just have some wonderful good luck and opportunities that you have not had and seen in many years. Now let's go over to this delightful reading. Six of Swords is continuing here. So we have you healing here. We have you moving ahead. We have you in the energy of being absolutely abundant. Look at what is coming in here for you. The Ten of Pentacles. That is a legacy marriage, typically partnership. It can be you building a legacy. It can be you inheriting a legacy, because that's what legacies are. But what we see is a time in your life when you are joyful, you are happy, you have done the work, you've been patient, you've taken that moment. The Star is also Aquarius energy. The healing, Six of Swords is Aquarius. It's the enlightenment. When we look at your 11th house, we're looking at this healing energy of the beautiful High Priestess, who is a healer. We see the Star card. Hopes and dreams for love coming true is literally the meaning of the card. We have the High Priestess energy. You know what you know, what you know, what you know. You are an amazing person. You are coming in. Look at this Ace of Coins. Remember I said the Ace of Coins, when paired with the Three of Cups, can bring a romance of a lifetime, maybe with somebody you've known, to the Empress energy. We have Emperor and Empress. We have a balanced energy for you, Cancer. This is Taurus energy. The Empress stands tall and proud. She's passionate. You are on your way to your Empress energy. Everything that you value, everything that you want, and you are going after it with all of the right energies this year. Cancer, it has been so special being with you. Thank you so much for your time. Sending you love from Chicago. Tell me where you're from. Send some love back, and I can't wait to talk to you throughout the year. Bye-bye.